Joe Fence in Texas.
So light!
Well, I'm still here at the Hilton Anito in Dallas, Texas. It's been quite an interesting turn of events. Right now, we're just talking to some of my friends about possibilities of growth in our district and what are the setbacks due to all that's been going on right now. Oh, I'm gonna sit down right here. Change is awesome. It can be scary, but sometimes we need change. The one thing I'm saying, and we've all been discussing, is basically we need to figure out some way to show the older generation, if you would, to help them ease into change. Let the younger generations start running with the bull, start taking care of things, start helping out and working and earning their trust so they can say that, hey, we are more adapted to the change and we can help you guys survive. Have you ever been kind of just disillusioned? No, not disillusioned. Have you ever been discouraged because maybe of your age? Because people think, you know what? You really can't do anything. Who are you? Maybe not so much age. Let's talk about maturity. Maybe you have history and you've changed. But people don't quite know how to deal with that. Don't know if you really are capable of such things. Been discouraged because of that. Well, really, right now, I really don't know what to tell you, honestly, because I'm a young person like you, and I have a past. I don't know why people have really opened up their doors and been so ready to let me in. Actually, I do know why. It's through two little things that I like to teach: obedience and faithfulness. It deals a lot with integrity and character. If you are constant in doing what is good, doing what is right, and like I say, be obedient to what God says in His Bible, then what you begin to see is there's a favor about you, there's a grace about you, and people start opening up trust and opening up doors to you. And that's God's favor. Sometimes it doesn't come easy, but God's favor can help open up doors for you. And I'm starting to see that. You know, just going to Mexico and seeing how things are just opening. And now I'm booked from July to September. September, I'm doing some worship conferences. And then October, my plans and hopes are to go to Monterrey or Saltillo, Coahuila, which is pretty much close. And in November, I'll be in Veracruz. December, I might go to Durango or Chiapas. I don't know. And then my next year, well, I'm not going to say it yet because there's certain people over there that don't know. But yeah, I'll be leaving the United States and be leaving Mexico and going to Europe for a while. And then Africa and then some other places. I'm nobody. You're probably just starting to get to know me. I'm nobody. But what I'm starting to do is obeying what God's doing, preparing His, working towards the dream He's put in my heart. Remember when I talked about dreams? And I'm starting to see His favor just open up and reveal itself. You know, it feels good to be back in Dallas. Changing the subject on you guys. I used to live here for about 4 years. Well, Waxahachie, Dallas. And then another year in Fort Worth. And I missed it. Just driving, even the climate. Feels pretty good to be back, but this is not my home. Not yet, anyway. Maybe in the future I'd like to have a house back in Fort Worth, Texas, but for now, it's out to the ends of the world, to where God is sending me. I'm excited, and just hope you're encouraged by that. this to my friends in the GLAD. I know that some of you are going to start looking at these videos and just to receive encouragement. My prayers are with you, just like I know that your prayers are with me. And I stand with the younger generation. I stand for change. I want to be a part of this impact. And I want to be a part of this transition. And you count with my vote. If you only know what God is opening up through me and the doors that you'll have available, the doors that will open up to you guys available through the ministry. I'm here, the ministry's here to serve you guys. So cheer up, man. You got one brother fine at your side, or standing firm at your side. Well, until next time, it's coming to you live. I am semi-live recorded from North Texas, Dallas, here at the Hilton and Tone. Much love and many blessings. I'm your friend, Josa.
Through